Hey there, today I'm here to explain myself. Well, I'm a bit late making this video, but as you may or may not know, I have quit Brown Dust a while back. Maybe a month ago by now, I don't know, but it's been a while. And well, as I have made this YouTube channel and kind of built a community around it, I feel like explaining myself and kind of give you some feedback on exactly what happened. First of all, I want to mention that I'm leaving this game in very good terms. I still think it's the best gacha out there. I really like the game, I really like the community. So what exactly happened? Well, it's both kind of a burnout because I've been playing this game for a while now and, you know, I'm very fickle with games. I usually quit them very fast. I'm actually surprised that I've sticked with Brown Dust for so long. I was definitely not expecting it. It's very common for me to play a game for like a week, maybe a month at most, and quit, play another one and keep going. I usually have problems sticking with games because they are cool while they're novelty, but after I get used to it, I just get bored very fast. But well, I stick with Brown Dust for like 6 months, more than 6 months, like almost a year. That's so much, that's amazing. Of course I didn't play the game for the whole duration, I kind of took breaks and everything, but wow, that's very unexpected for me. So it's not like why am I quitting, it's why I have played the game for so long. But anyway, let's get to the actual reasons. So first of all, Brown Dust is kind of an interesting game in the fact that it's quite based around PvP. Of course, PvE is a thing, it's fun, I like it, it's skill-based still, but it's not exactly durable. Like, you clear the content and you're done with it, and the game doesn't incentivize farming per se. So, you're pretty much doing your campaign or your evil castle, and after like a month, maybe two at most, you're kinda done with most of it. Like, you're just missing a few stages that are super hard and don't care about too much. And at that point, you don't have anything to do in terms of PvE. So, really, the selling point of Brown Dust is 100% PvP. That is absolutely fine, I really like PvP. But as a gacha, it just doesn't work too well. So gachas in general are pay to win. You have like a few exceptions here and there, but in general, it's a genre known for having a lot of pay to win transactions. And as much as I like defending this game, it's also true for Brown Dust. So the game is very free to play friendly compared to all the gachas, in my opinion. I think it's a really good spot in the gacha genre. But in general, it's still very pay to win, and it shows way more in this game because it is based around PvP. So since the only thing that matters in this game is PvP, and of course, you could be a casual and just play PvP for fun, but really, when it's a game based around PvP, it's kind of incentivized to be somewhat competitive and care about your rankings and everything. And at that point, well, being free to play in a game with pay to win just doesn't feel good at all. But I knew that, I've always known that. The fact is that you can kind of compensate for that for just being a good player, managing your resources well, but then comes the second problem, which is RNG. The game is heavy on RNG, as any other gacha of course, but the fact is that if you're free to play, you really need to gamble a lot. Okay, of course you have a way where you're gambling as well, it's a gacha, it's a gamble, but if you fail as a free to play, you save everything you have, you try to pull, you be like 100% efficient, you do the best you can, and try to pull, and it doesn't work out, you're fucked. You know, it's not gonna happen. You're gonna be low ranked in arena, you're gonna have a bad time playing the game, and of course, as your performance is so tied to the characters you have, if you don't, one, pay, or two, get good RNG, or at least average RNG, you're not gonna perform well. Even if you play every day, do everything you can, be 100% efficient, you're not gonna perform well, you're not gonna have a good time. That's a huge problem. At the very top of the competitive PvP game mode, you're gonna have the whales that are lucky, then the whales that are unlucky, the dolphins that are lucky, the dolphins that are unlucky, and then the free-to-play players that are lucky, and the very last, the free-to-play players that are unlucky. And that's a huge problem because you're 100% rely on RNG, which isn't fun. And in the end, just creates like a very frustrating game where, well, if you pull good units, you're happy, it feels amazing, but at like most of the time where you're just trying to be efficient, doing your thing, saving for months and finally pulling, trying to get the unit that you want, the unit that you need, and then you get nothing, it just feels absolutely terrible. Of course, I also knew that, but after experiencing it in first hand, I just kind of felt like quitting. Like, I had been saving for a huge while, like more than a month, and I saved like almost 300 pulls, it was like 250 plus, I don't know exactly how many. And as the Lackless Edwin banner arrived, I just went all in. And of course, I pulled absolutely nothing, 0 5 stars. And that really just pushed me to quit the game. It felt horrible to think that the past month that I've been playing, doing my dailies, which aren't even fun, it feels like a job to just open the game and do your things and, okay, I gotta clear these dailies, okay, I gotta do this, I gotta do that so I can get crystals. And at the end, after a month, you get absolutely nothing and you think that the last month you've been doing this was 100% useless. It just feels terrible. And terrible not only in-game, my whole day was terrible. And you know, if I'm playing a game that is supposed to make me have fun, but the game functions in a way that you're only really having fun half of the time when you're pulling the units you want, and the other half you're getting absolutely destroyed by the game, and which makes you feel terrible. I mean, why would I play such a game? If a thing that is designed to put you up actually puts you down, I mean, I'm done with it. And once again, I feel like explaining this. Don't get me wrong, this is not specific to Brown Dust. This is a thing, a problem with gachas in general, which is why I'm quitting gachas in general, not specifically Brown Dust. As I mentioned, I think Brown Dust is still the best gacha in the market. I still think it's quite free-to-play friendly compared to all the PvP competitive gacha games, but it's still a gacha. It still has all these problems. And I can still see myself playing another gacha in the future if it's a gacha based around PvE with very forgiving pull rates and more focus around your own progression, like an MMORPG. I can kinda see myself playing that, but in general, I'll try to stay away from the genre. So, okay, I'm quitting because of pay to win and RNG. Well, not exactly, there's more to it. I could still maybe have a lot of fun in the game that is pay to win and has a lot of RNG, but the main problem with gachas in general, once again, is that it's binary RNG. What I mean by that is that usually in MMORPGs, you do have some pay to win games, you do have some RNG involved, but in the end, it only really affects like your gear and that kind of thing. So someone that got like way more lucky than you, maybe has like 3% more damage than you, maybe someone that is a huge whale has like 10% more stats than you do, and you can still play the game and have a lot of fun that way. You can still PvP with that guy and outplay him and win, but in gacha games, it's very binary in the sense that you want the unit, it's just absolutely broken, you need it to progress, but, well, you either have the unit or you don't. You either pulled it or you didn't. You go into this huge pull session after you saved a lot of time, and there are two results. You either pulled the unit or you didn't. And having the unit is great, you get it, you're strong, amazing. But if you don't, that's a huge disadvantage. It's not 2% worse or even 10% worse. It's 100% worse. You don't have the unit at all. And that is why it just feels absolutely terrible to go through bad RNG. So let's say there's like a number gacha that helps your account somehow by giving you power or something like that. So you pull different numbers. Let's say the average for a pull session would be like 100 points. Well, if you're unlucky, maybe you get like 80 points. Wow. And someone that gets super lucky gets maybe 120 points. As you can see, there's still kind of a difference, but it's very mediocre. You can overcome that. It's not that bad. When it comes to binary RNG, it's 1 or 0. You get the unit or you don't. It's absolutely terrible. But anyway, enough rambling. You get the idea. RNG is bad. Pay to win is bad. Okay. Now I want to mention that as I quit the game, I'm also quitting my occupations as a moderator of the community subreddit and Discord service from Brown Dust. And the reason for that is actually quite simple. I don't play the game anymore, so I just don't feel like doing it anymore. Hopefully that makes as much sense to you as it does to me. It's actually something quite time consuming, and actually spending that time in a game that I don't play anymore just doesn't feel right to me. I'd rather do something else with my time. But then, what will be off the channel? Well, to be honest, I have absolutely no idea. Like, I really like doing these videos, it feels really nice, it's been like a very fun ride, and I'm gonna keep doing it, of course. But I don't know exactly in what direction we're gonna shoot. Like, I'm playing different games right now, I could just cover those games, but I'm not sure if the community will like that. And in general, I've built a community very specific to Brown Dust, and as I'm quitting the game, I'm expecting the community to not follow me as I go to a different one. That's absolutely fine, that's also what I would do if I were in your position. But as I start covering a different game and start interacting with a new community, hopefully I can gather some viewers from that community specifically, as I'll probably have to start very close to Ground Zero. I'm currently playing Hearthstone as a side game, and I think it's just a very fun game to record and make videos on. It just works really well and it's not that hard. So I might do that kind of thing as a more edited type of video, but I also want to do commentary because I find it very enjoyable. So I have absolutely no idea in what way to shoot. There's so many different things that I want to cover as a YouTube channel, and when you finally go around to make one, you just don't know what way to shoot because you kind of have to focus your channel around something, right? You just can't do everything. It's not gonna work too well. And I'm still not very sure what I'm gonna be doing, but as I have more of an idea, I'll kind of let you guys know. So that is about it. Feel free to comment and ask me any other questions about the game, why I quit, my opinion on something, that's absolutely fine. I'll try to answer all comments as usual. And well, that's pretty much it. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you